up, my dudes? It is day 6 of Vlogmas 2020 COVID Christmas. And as you can see, I am wearing the exact same outfit as yesterday. That is because I literally only got dressed just for that hockey game, so these clothes aren't dirty. And the first thing I have to do today is I have like a talk back kind of thing for the one act. And so I'm not sure what's going to be happening there. I don't know if I'm going to get to film that. I might try to. So I'm getting ready for that to look presentable. What else? I have to go practice piano today, and Jack's going to be helping me. So definitely getting in some filming there. I have 2 meetings, one for my Tri Sigma chapter meeting, and then another is I'm being transitioned into my new chair position, and I might be hanging out with Andrew depending on if he gets his homework done. So yeah, it's gonna be a very eventful day today, and stay tuned for all the activities. Okay, Vlad, here I am all made up for the talk back. I'm not really sure how this is gonna go. I'm just here because
for fun.
This is the Zoom meeting. We have some of the actors, directors, and playwrights of all the productions that we did. So when things get up and running, I will try to find them.
We had the wonderful opportunity of collaborating with First Run Theater, which is of course a local theater company focusing on developing new work from area playwrights in the region. We have several of those board members here with us today, but one in particular, Mr. Rob Miller, who is going to actually be the facilitator of this talk back. So I am going to turn things over to him after I just mentioned, if you haven't had an opportunity to look in the chat and to understand how we're working things, please, when you have a question or if you want to comment based on any of Rob's questions that he puts forth, please feel free to turn on your mic and your camera to join us. No pressure. You certainly could just turn on your mic. Or if you're having technical difficulties, feel free to type it in the chat. The students are very good at following the chat. much better than I am. So Rob, thank you for being here, and take it away.
All right, the plays themselves. Off the top of your head, just a few words or a phrase about your immediate reaction to the play itself, more so than to the directing of the play. You know, it might be a comment like it needs more work, or it has interesting characters, or it's touching. Let's go through the plays in order. So Thank You for Calling by Tim Henderson. What's an immediate reaction that someone has to that particular play?
Well, I directed it, and my first read-through, there's clearly not really a message or a deeper meaning. I think it's just comedy for comedy's sake, and that's one of the reasons why I chose it, because 2020 kind of sucks right now. So I think we all needed a good laugh, and we definitely got that through the rehearsal process and tech and everything.
Yeah, good point. You know, plays are meant to make us think. They're also meant to make us laugh and be entertained. Timothy, did you have something you wanted to mention there? I saw some movement. No?
We're in the same room. Kenzie and I are in the same room, so I have to unmute so she can talk.
Oh, I gotcha. Okay. Any other comments about Tim's play, Thank You for Calling?
I do, actually. When I watch things, I don't think of any deeper, you know, I take it at face value. So his name, I didn't get until the very end. Until I was like, oh my God, yeah, I knew that. Like, what am I? I laughed, like, seriously, like, out loud. It was amazing.
Well, it sounds like it was well done. McKenzie.
My characters weren't defined at all,
Because Patrick is a prank caller, so we don't know his real identity. And all we know about Lydia is her age and the fact that she has no kids. So it was really interesting to, like, come up with our own version of the characters between me, the director, and the actors. We sort of got a general idea of Patrick through callbacks that he was, you know, living in his parents' basement and, like, unemployed, and that slowly evolved into smelly college boy who is, like, alone in his dorm room prank calling. So I think it was really fun to have the creative freedom to develop those characters and find little quirks about each of them.
Hi, so I played Lydia in Thank You for Calling, and I just thought this was, like, one of the most fun rehearsal processes because, like Kenzie said, there's not a lot of information about either of these characters, so that was, like, a great opportunity to, you know, just play and, like, discover, because we did, like, a lot of exercises and playing around with, like, how can we do something different to make it interesting, and there was, like, a lot of, like, pauses and moments of silence that we played around with. So, like, I would always try to think, like, if I was, like, in an awkward situation, like, what would I do to, you know, fill the air, fill the space? And so one of the things I did was I was looking around, like, all the things on my desk in my dorm when we were playing around. I'm just like, oh, I have some chapstick. Like, what if I just put on some chapstick? And Kenzie's like, yes, do that. And I was just like, okay, because, like, I was just, like, doing normal things. And it's, like, that can, like, just, like, simple normal things can fill the space and, like, be comedic. And whenever the character of Patrick was flirting with me, I would think, how would I, like, genuinely react if, like, someone was saying this to me over the phone? So it gave me, like, the chance to be very expressive. And I'm just, like, I'm really one for sketch comedy, like, for things like SNL and stuff like that. So I drew, like, a lot of inspiration from that. It was just, like, so much fun to, like, you know, just play. It's, like, it didn't have to be serious. It didn't, like, there was, like, no, like, deeper meaning to anything we did. So that, like, it was just fun to explore, like, in a fun and childish way.
I can imagine it'd be fun. There's so much subtext, I would think, that come out of just a gesture, you know, that you can bring so much out in a play that's not dialogue, just with the choices you make with facial expressions and gestures and so on. All right, other things about...
But what's up, vlog? I just got Jack, and we are going to practice piano at Lindenwood. Because I have a piano final that I have not practiced for because I don't have access to a piano.
She said, bring home your piano. And I said, you want to lug it down those stairs? Carry it all the way to my home? Go for it. Then you have to bring it back, too.
I wasn't about to do that.
Exactly. That's why it's not here. That's why it's locked in my dorm room for November and most of January. December and most of January, my bad.
Yep. Well, do you have, like, it doesn't have to be, like, a new fact, but just something you already know that you haven't shared.
Oh. You were about to ask that. I'm not prepared in the slightest. God, what's an interesting fact that I could share? Let me look.
You share about a million things a day on your Instagram.
I know, but, like, you're telling me to come up with one specific fact right
now. Anything about mental health, anything about...
Oh, okay. Some odd symptoms of anxiety that you may know that physically betray themselves is intestinal issues and also profuse sweating.
I actually didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's a good fact. Thank you so much for sharing that.
You're welcome.
Okay, we will see you guys at Lindenwood to play some piano.
Did you not really know that?
No, I seriously didn't know.
Oh, okay, cool.
We are struggling. We've, like, changed songs a million times, but I think we've settled on one that seems easy.
You've settled on one.
Yes.
You could just play that twice if you wanted to, and then that would count as your 16 bars. Are you still filming?
Yes, I am.
Oh, God.
So is that the way you normally play it, or is this, like, a different key?
No, this is the same key.
Okay, cool. So.
Yeah.
Wait, let me see if they start on those same notes, too. I mean, they should. Yeah.
Hi, vlog. I'm back from playing piano, and this dummy's here. Ow. My mom didn't get me food, so now we have to do something about that. But I don't know what food to get.
Healthy food.
I feel like I'm being called out.
No, everyone needs healthy food.
Where can we get healthy food?
Anywhere.
Okay. Whoa, I'm being attacked. Whoa! So, I'll let you guys know where I end up getting food. Don't do that. I'll let you guys know where I end up getting food. So, I'll be back in a hot minute. Hey, vlog. So, we ended up getting Steak and Shake. Andrew ate food that was supposed to be mine.
She got free fries. What can I say?
Yeah, they weren't for you. Mm-hmm. They weren't meant to be for you. We shared a shake. That was the thing we agreed upon. And right now we're watching a reality TV dating show called Are You the One? I love this stuff, but Andrew's not a fan.
It's fun to make fun of. That's all.
Well, at least you're getting some sort of enjoyment out of it. Mm. Oh! Whoa. So, I don't know. We might do other stuff. Some other activities.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, so again, I'll be back.
So it's dark down here because I dimmed down the lights. But right now, what movie are we watching, Andrew?
Love Actually.
Have you...
What?
Oh, you gassed. I was going to say...
The movie's playing. I'm trying to watch it.
Have you seen this movie?
No, we have not.
Hell yeah, I also haven't seen this movie. I'm
trying to get it.
Mm-hmm. So, vlog, I think this is where I'm going to leave you today.
Copyright her.
I will be seeing y'all tomorrow morning.
That's good.
That's great. Okay. Thank you, Andrew. Mm-hmm. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!
Good morning, vlog. It is day 7 of Vlogmas 2020 COVID Christmas, and I have a final this morning. I'm waiting to be let into the Zoom meeting. I'm in my room. Andrew's downstairs, still sleeping on the couch. I'm very tired as well. I have to do my scene today. I have to do a monologue. So I'll try to film what I can, you know? I might film myself because I don't know. I don't want to. Because we had a discussion in class because we were toying with the idea of having like people come in and watch us, but we just kind of discussed that this was a studio class and this should just be for us, so I kind of want to respect that, so I'll only film myself.
Hi, my name is Moira Healy and I will be performing a monologue from And Baby Makes Seven by Paula Vogel. You two traipse in and out of here at all hours of the day while I sit here bloated and tethered like some goddamn Goodyear blimp on Super Bowl day. And I'm supposed to give up coffee, smoking, drink, spicy foods, and I'm expected to be understanding of what Ruth wants and what Peter needs. Well, who some kind of knocked up Miss Manners? It's 90 degrees in August and I can't get a seat on the subway. I hate New York and... I just want to see my knees again. I want to kill, maim, and moan the neighbors! Also, it would be nice if Peter could pick up his shoes instead of leaving them in the middle of the floor for me to trip over so I don't have to worry about dropping the goddamn baby in a burst of placental juice all over the floor! Don't say it. Don't you dare say it. You both can suck my imaginary. And don't tell me it's hormones! Thank you.
That was a return to sweetness. Okay, good. Thanks, Moira.
Thank you. Hey, vlog. I just finished my acting final. Yeah. And I think I did pretty good.
Mm-hmm. She did amazing.
Oh, thank you, Andrew. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I didn't film my scene because I forgot to, but I filmed my monologue, so that's cool. So yeah, I'll let you know if other things are happening today.
Hey vlog, so I'm in the car. I'm at the gas station. I'm waiting for Andrew to get back from, I think he's getting snacks or something. But yeah, I just had to fill up my tank. And we are going to get some food. Then we're going back to his house to watch the rest of Love Actually, because like I literally fell asleep with like in the first 20 minutes. So yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing at his house. He's coming back. What'd you get, Paige? I love Snapple.
I got a
Kiwi. That's funny. That's cute. What?
It's for you. Guys, you gotta witness this moment. Will you be my ring pop girlfriend?
Yeah. Why didn't you put it on my ring finger?
Because your ring finger's over there.
No. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Also, it probably wouldn't fit. Okay, it fit.
It fits. I have small fingers. Wow, what a momentous occasion that we just got here. That's funny, because I told you should give me a ring pop.
Did you?
Yeah.
I don't remember that. I just saw it, and I was like, okay.
Okay.
Well, actually, we got Subway, and this is Andrew's dog, Winnie.
You were gonna watch Love last night. Did you even tell him that?
Yeah, I did.
Did you tell him why we didn't?
Because I fell asleep.
Because we both fell asleep. We were tired.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is his dog, Winnie. She's really cute. What kind of a dog is she?
A cute one?
No, but like what breed?
I have no idea. No, I don't.
And she's so tiny and she loves attention. See, I stopped petting her and she wants more. are we gonna watch it, Andrew?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Ooh!
Wants me more.
That's okay. Where's the cat?
Oh.
Where's the cat?
Don't matter.
The cat loves me more than you. You know that, right?
Well, Winnie's cuter than the cat. No, she does. The cat always comes up to me, dude. Fucking jumping on me.
Yeah, but when I'm here, he loves me more.
No.
Yes.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm-mm. Bet. I bet you. What'd you say?
Stop it. Stop filming me.
But you're so cute.
Mm. Nah. I could do this to you instead if you just put it on the phone.
Okay. So, we finished watching the movie. Kind of fell asleep at parts because I'm so tired. But this is Binks. This is Andrew's cat. And he's so sweet. I love to pet him. And he loves attention. And for look at that. Andrew, I know I just agreed that we weren't gonna cheat, but then this cat came and no!
Tea.
Thank you, but the cat.
Okay, but you got tea now.
How'd you heat this up?
Hot water.
Did you not put this in the microwave?
That's
what
you do.
Oops.
You steep it. You don't have to do that. You can just get it as hot as, like, you know, when the water's so hot that it's just burning. Yeah, just heat it up that hot and then steep the tea bag.
How'd you heat the water?
You turned it on hot.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah. Hey, vlog. Whoa! Whoa! Whoa, sir! Whoa, sir! Yes.
Even better.
Whoa! Anyways, we're back being fat because we got little Caesars. Andrew, would you like, you always have some like good words of wisdom. Like, what's a wisdom you can give the viewers?
Just
Well, you wouldn't approve of anything I had to say. Well, yeah, I really can't say any of the things that are coming to mind.
Why?
Because they're all great life advice, but not appropriate for you too.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, what's an appropriate wisdom?
Nugs, not drugs.
Okay, that's valid. Thank you so much.
Oh, I said that wrong. I said that in reverse.
No.
Wait, drugs, then nugs.
No, we're gonna... Other way around.
Oh, okay.
Thank you for your wisdom.
So, nugs, then drugs?
Nugs, not drugs, kids. Don't pay attention to him. I know it's dark. I didn't turn on my car light. Hang on, I can do that now. So, hey, vlog, I'm leaving Andrew's house now. Because he's got to work tomorrow, but I most likely will be at his house tomorrow, too. Because that's the pattern. We just got to switch off at whose house we're at. Tomorrow, I would have had my piano final, but I need an extension because I don't have a piano to practice on. So, I'm just sending in a video. So, that's great. Shout out to my teacher for being such a help. And so understanding, but yeah, and I also have to film my, voice final tomorrow too, so that's cool. I also have an assignment due tonight, which I really need to do. Am I gonna get it finished? Who knows? That's like the fun of it, you know? It's a little adventure, but you know, thank you for following me around, today, whether you thought it was eventful or not. I always do my best to try to document things you might think is interesting. So I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.